Так, друзі, всіх вітаю. Всім дуже дякую, що приєдналися. Наталія, я зробила тебе кохостом, щоб ти, може, запускала людей, поки я говорю. Да? Дуже дякую всім студентам, всім школярам, їх батькам, я тут бачу і батьків, що приєдналися сьогодні для того, щоб дізнатися більше про програму RISE. Ми почали працювати з цією програмою буквально там місяць тому. І ми дуже з цього приводу радіємо, бо чим більше таких програм, як RISE і Ukraine Global Scholars виходять, знаєте, на ринок України, да, і взагалі на глобальний ринок, тим краще, перш за все, нашим школярам, які можуть через різними шляхами отримати найбажаніше, те, що вони хочуть навчатися за кордоном, отримати найкращу освіту безкоштовно. І сьогодні ми розкажемо вам саме про що говорить RISE, яких студентів, школярів він, на яких студентів він чекає, як відбувається процес відбору, ось, і що ж чекає на призерів цієї чудової програми, ким вона створена, і обов'язково на всі ваші питання ми дамо відповідь. Я хотіла сказати, що сьогодні також у нас на колі разом зі мною я є Юлією Лемеш, президентом фонду Ukraine Global Scholars, зараз знаходжусь тут в Америці. Ось разом зі мною тут на колі є представник RISE Грегорі Мені. Ось і ви бачите його, да, тут в нього є таке лого RISE. І також є Наталія Кулішова. Вона є фіналісткою Ukraine Global Scholars і фіналісткою RISE. Тобто така чудова комбінація. Ми навіть на таке не мріяли, щоб вона все це володіла, змогла це все досягти. Але це чудова комбінація, і про яку вона сьогодні також розкаже. Так ось, якщо говорити про Грегорі, він зараз знаходиться в Нью-Йорку, на Манхеттені, до речі, передаю вам всім привіт. Він є менеджером по відбору та глобальному рекрутингу в RISE. До цього він працював в коледжі Ліги Плюща, що зветься Дартмус. Я думаю, що ви всі знаєте цей коледж, ну, всі, хто мріє про закордонну освіту. Ось, і також хотіла сказати, що у Грегора, у Грега є ступінь від Гарвардської школи освіти, а також він навчався в Бостонському коледжі, отримав там свій бакалаврат. Ось, через буквально пару хвилин я представлю, дам йому слово, щоб він розказав більше про програму RISE. Але перед тим, як я представлю нашу Наташу, я просто хотіла спитати, хто на цьому колі не володіє англійською мовою. Це важливо для того, щоб розуміти, чи переклад потрібен, чи не потрібен. Якщо можна, просто напишіть в загальному чаті «I don't speak English». Ну, just, или там «Я не володію англійською». Просто напишіть в цьому чаті, бо це важливо для нас розуміти, як правильно вибудувати сьогодні нашу бесіду. Добре? Напишіть, будь ласка. Якщо ніхто нам не написав, будемо розуміти, що всі тут розуміють англійську мову і що переклад не потрібен. Добре? Чекаємо на цей меседж, що всі розуміють англійську мову. Так, і зараз я хочу представити все ж таки нашу фіналістку Наталію Кулішову. Вона є... Зараз Наталі 17 років. До речі, вона подалася на RISE, коли їй було 16 років. Через пару днів їй вже виповнилось 17. Вона є зі Слов'янську Донецької області. Вона є зі Слов'янської Донецької області, і вона завдяки Ukraine Global Scholars вступила в школу Masters, школа пенсіон, вона знаходиться в Нью-Йорку, в штаті Нью-Йорку. Ось, і вона, Наталія, випуститься з цієї чудової школи в 2023 році і вже буде завдяки програмі RISE мати повну стипендію в будь-який коледж світу, куди вона і не вступить. Так? Okay, I see a couple people who do not speak English here, so we will need to translate. That's cool. It's fine. Ми будемо перекладати, нічого поганого в цьому немає. Okay, now then over to you, Greg. I introduced you all, and you know, good luck with the presentation. Thank you so much for joining us today. I know it's holiday for you, and well, not only holiday, it's a weekend, but we really appreciate your time and joining us for the session today. Thank you, Greg.
No problem. Thank you so much, Julia. I'm really excited to be here, and I'm super appreciative of the time and energy you took to put this event together, and really excited about the opportunity to collaborate with Ukrainian global scholars and with all the wonderful young people that you work with. We're really thrilled to have here today Nataliia, one of the global winners, who will be talking more about her experiences with RISE as part of the presentation. So might as well go ahead and get started with our group here. So I'm just going to share my presentation. And the way this is going to work is here's the agenda and the plan for today. I would ask you now, if you have a moment and you have your phone with you, to please feel free, if you haven't already, to scan the QR code on this agenda page and to download the Hello World app, which is the main way by which you can apply and join the RISE community. Once you've done that, we'll be talking more about RISE specifically. I'll be presenting in English about the program and the goals of the program, what we offer, how you join. And then Nataliia will be talking about her experiences and translating much of what I, you know, a summary of what I'm saying into Ukrainian, because my Ukrainian, I haven't had enough time to practice this weekend, unfortunately. After we do that, we will be taking questions and answers from you all. So we'll spend the second half of the presentation, just any questions you have, you know, Julia and Nataliia and I will do our best to answer based on our knowledge of the collaboration and Ukraine and RISE and so on and so forth. Last but not least, I'll ask you, after you've downloaded the app, to please start filling out stage one. And we'll talk more about what the stages of the experience are when it comes to RISE. So that's the plan. Again, thank you so much to UGS for having us, for organizing. It's really great to be working with you all. And thank you to Nataliia for joining us to share her experiences. And you'll be hearing from her in just a minute. So let's jump in. Before we do, let me actually pause and Nataliia, why don't you just quickly introduce yourself? I know Julia gave an introduction, and then just go over kind of what I said on the last screen, if you want, quick version.
Так, всім привіт. Мене звуть Наталія. І те, що Грек сказав, це те, що у нас буде сьогодні на колі. Перш ніж ми почнемо, будь ласка, просканіть цей QR-код. Це посилання на додаток, через який ви будете подаватись на RISE. Також після того, як ви просканували, ми будемо говорити про те, що таке RISE, що треба зробити або податись на цю програму, що ви можете отримати як фіналіст. Потім ми проведемо невелику Q&A-сесію. І після цього Грек просив нагадати про те, що ми будемо дуже вдячні, якщо ви будете заповнювати першу форму для RISE, про яку ми будемо говорити пізніше.
Thank you. So, talking a little bit about what is RISE. So we are a global program founded by Schmidt Futures and the Rhodes Trust. For those of you who don't know, Schmidt Futures is Eric and Wendy Schmidt's venture for social good. Eric Schmidt is the former CEO of Google. And we are working in partnership on this program with the Rhodes Trust. The Rhodes Trust works out of Oxford University in the United Kingdom and oversees one of the oldest and most prestigious scholarship programs, the Rhodes Scholarship Program. Our purpose is to find brilliant young people like Nataliia, and bring them opportunity. That's the idea. The purpose is to help people with great talent between the ages of 15 and 17 use those talents for good. Our philosophy is that brilliance and intelligence are equally distributed around the world, but opportunity is not. So we must bring opportunity to that talent and then motivate that talent to use their abilities to help make society, their community, their schools, their neighborhoods, better places, to improve the world in some way. We want people to focus, you know, who have this high level of intelligence, on using that ability to solve the world's big problems. So this is just a quick overview of who we are. I'm going to cover one more slide here about what makes RISE unique and different and special from any other program. And then I'm going to allow Nataliia to do some translation and also answer a question I have for her. So first and foremost, although we are open for application to 15 to 17 year olds, the program is for life. So if you are selected as a member of the global winning cohort, you'll be supported in your 20s, your 30s, your 40s, and we'll talk more about what that looks like. We're also a global community. We have representation from all over the world. We have partnerships in many different countries, and I'll give some more statistics and background about that also. And then last but not least, we're looking for brilliance and intelligence, but we're doing so through methods that are very innovative. We are not using grades. We are not asking for essays or test scores from a standardized examination. Instead, we are using project-based video concepts, peer review, socialization to help locate the next generation of brilliant young people with talent who can change the world for the better. So I'm gonna pause here and I'm gonna invite Nataliia to talk a little bit about everything that I've reviewed in Ukrainian. And then Nataliia, if you wouldn't mind sharing with us, one, how you found out about RISE, and two, what your experience with the global community has been, what it's been like to be part of something that's so international.
Отож, про програму RISE. Програма RISE була організована колишнім генеральним директором Google Еріком Шмітом та його дружиною у партнерстві з Road Trust. Це організація, яка надає, яка співпрацює з Оксфордським університетом та надає одну із найдавніших та найпрестижніших стипендій в академічних стипендій у світі. Філософія RISE така, що талант та талановиті люди є усюди, але не у всіх є можливості для того, щоб повністю реалізувати свій потенціал. І для цього існує RISE, щоб надавати рівні можливості для всіх тих, хто має потенціал зробити цей світ кращим. RISE шукає людей, які будуть протягом свого життя використовувати свої знання для того, щоб допомагати усім людям жити краще і вирішувати глобальні проблеми. Отож, також RISE – це не просто програма на кілька років, RISE – це програма на все життя. Тобто, коли ви стаєте фіналістом RISE, ви стаєте фіналістом навіть у 50 і 60 років, і також ви стаєте частиною дуже глобального ком'юніті. Тобто зараз в нашій когорті RISE, якщо не помиляюсь, представники більше ніж 140 країн, 50 країн, а подалось більше ніж 140 країн світу. І, як на мене, мені дуже подобається цей досвід бути частиною такого глобального ком'юніті через те, що зараз з тобою є друзі з усього світу, ти дізнаєшся багато нового про різні культури, ти вчиш багато різних мов на дуже низькому рівні, але все одно. І, як на мене, це просто неймовірний досвід, який кожен має отримати у 21 столітті. Я дізналася про RISE з реклами в Фейсбуці. Тоді ще ніхто ніколи не чув про RISE. І я подалась. І зараз мені подобається, що RISE став більш популярнішим серед підростків. І що є вже реальні фіналісти, до яких ви можете звернутися з різними питаннями, які зможуть вам допомогти віднайти відповіді.
And so just to review really quickly a little bit about the community that we have, there were tens of thousands of applicants to RISE from over 170 countries, and all of these people became members of our community, these young people who were able to participate in many of our beneficial opportunities, which I'll talk about more. We had 500 finalists, a number who were from Ukraine, from 72 countries. We had 100 global winners. Nataliia is one of them, from 42 countries, of course, one of them being from Ukraine. We have over 30 partnerships, 300 collaborations across 6 continents. So we are very much indeed spanning the world in just our first year. What do we offer? So the first thing you have to know about RISE is just by joining the community, there will be benefits to all those who apply. You join by filling out, by downloading the app on Hello World and just filling out the first phase of the application. And by doing so, you are able to unlock free courses that we offer, expert lessons with famous instructors such as Yalda Akim, a famous journalist from the BBC, who taught a course on your point of difference. Angela Duckworth, a famous education professor at the University of Pennsylvania, taught a course about grit. We also have workshops that we offer through some of our partners and in coordination with some of our partners. These are a few of the examples with people we had featured from the University of Oxford that we were able to connect with because of our alliance with the Rhodes Trust. And we also had an Ask Me Anything events with various famous entrepreneurs, one example being Sal Khan, who is a famous education social impact entrepreneur in the US and presented on using on kind of how to tell your story through video and how and his experiences with Khan Academy. So I'll pause there. And Nataliia, if you wouldn't mind talking a little bit about what I just spoke about, but also sharing any of the free opportunities that you took advantage of when you joined the RISE community at the first stage last year.
Отож, не обов'язково ставати фіналістом RISE, щоб отримати якісь бенефіти. Тобто, як тільки ви подаєтесь на RISE, для вас відкривається багато можливостей, таких як безкоштовні курси, безкоштовні вебінари від багатьох дуже успішних людей, багатьох професорів з Оксфорду, з, наприклад, також багатьох підприємців, як Сал Кхан, хто створив Khan Academy. І я також брала кілька курсів, я також відвідала цю сесію з Салом Кханом. Як на мене, це було дуже корисно, коли перед тобою сидить людина, яка досягла дуже багато всього, яка зробила дуже великий внесок у розвиток соціального руху серед молоді, яка намагається навчатись саморозвитком. І мені було приємно, що RISE надав можливість задати будь-які питання, які у вас є, і всі ці люди, вони були тут, щоб розказати, поділитися своїм досвідом і допомогти стати вам більш успішними у вашому житті.
We also had community events as part of the RISE experience. So there's opportunities for the young people to socialize with each other from all over the world. This is a picture from our global gathering for good. Obviously our events right now are taking place virtually because of the pandemic, but we hope to be able to offer live in-person events as well in the future. At these events, kids can share their talent. They can get to know each other. They played music, read poems, shared art. We also have a Discord community that you can join once you've completed stage one. And in the Discord community, there are many channels for you to interact based on your interests or areas that you want to learn more about with other people from around the world. So you may talk about sports or fashion or culture or academic subjects like literature and history with the other young people who are members of the RISE community. Nataliia, do you mind talking a little bit about any kind of social experiences you had as a result of being a member of RISE?
Тож, коли ви заповнюєте першу частину аплікаційної форми у RISE, ви можете доєднатися до багатьох ком'юніті-івентів, наприклад, Zoom-івенти або в канали в Discord. І що було приємно, те, що у RISE ком'юніті дуже багато людей, і я можу гарантувати, що ви знайдете хоча б одну людину, яка буде повністю, з якою ви знайдете спільну мову. Можливо, завдяки таким каналам ви зможете поділитися різними ідеями у сфері ваших інтересів, ви зможете знайти нових друзів і, можливо, навіть нових партнерів для своїх майбутніх проєктів.
So just to review a bit about the benefits of being a member of the RISE community, anybody who joins is able to benefit, which is really important thing to understand. It is a transformative experience. It is a free experience. It is an inclusive experience. Everyone receives opportunities via our partners and our online programming that we offer if they join our community. After joining the community, we then also offer the RISE Challenge, which is what we'll be talking about next. Challenge is the actual social impact project competition that we host as part of the RISE experience. For that experience, we then select 500 finalists, and we'll talk about our process for how we do that in a moment. Those finalists also receive special benefits that not everyone is eligible for. So they receive their own free opportunities for leadership courses. Finalists receive Duolingo English testing waivers they could use to apply for a university or to verify their English language ability, and as well as additional funding opportunities that we're still rolling out at this moment. And then last but not least, we have the global winners here, like Nataliia, and the global winners have a lifetime of benefits. This includes need-based scholarships, a residential summit, which we'll be hosting for 3 weeks, where all of the kids will get to come together and meet each other in person. Mentorship and career services programming, as well as possibilities for graduate scholarships for studying master's, and funding for potential ideas for social impact and enterprise and connections to the network with Schmidt Futures and the Rhodes Trust. So talking a little bit about how do you apply and how do you access those benefits. First and foremost, we invite anyone between the ages of 15 and 17, born between July 1st, 2004 and July 1st, 2007, to join our community via the Hello World app or through one of our other pathways. We do have an online web browser pathway if you do not have a cell phone, as well as a written paper pathway, which you can access on our website as well. I'll pause there just so Nataliia can explain a little bit about what I've been talking about before we get into the outline of the actual process for applying for the projects.
Отож, коли ви подаєтесь на RISE, ви стаєте частиною глобального ком'юніті, і як ми вже говорили раніше, ви отримуєте доступ до багатьох курсів, до багатьох вебінарів. Потім, якщо ви пройдете у топ-500 фіналістів, ви отримаєте також доступ вже до більш масштабних курсів. Також ви отримаєте фі-вейвери для тесту з англійського Duolingo, які ви можете використовувати для подачі в університети за кордоном. І якщо ви приходите у топ-100 глобальних фіналістів, ви отримаєте безліч можливостей протягом всього свого життя, включаючи повний грант для освіти за кордоном у будь-якому університеті, який вам захочеться. Потім ви отримаєте підтримку з пошуком стажувань та роботи. Ви отримуєте ментора, який буде вам допомагати з будь-яким питанням. Ви також маєте можливість відвідати саміт фіналістів, офлайн-саміт фіналістів, де усі 100 фіналістів зберуться і будуть разом навчатись і вирішувати різні проблеми протягом 3 тижнів.
And so the process through which you can participate in the challenge to be eligible for the benefits of being a finalist or winner are the following. First, you must download the app and fill out stage one, which is really just bio demo information and a few short videos, which you will complete on your profile. And you need to do that before the 22nd of December of this year. Once you've completed stage one, which takes 20 to 30 minutes, more or less, you then unlock the ability to start the project. If you finish stage one tomorrow, you can start tomorrow. If you finish stage one on December 15th, then you can start on the 15th. If you finish on the last day, then you can start on the last day. So the earlier you finish stage one, the sooner you can start on the project. The project is a 20 to 30 hour time commitment, and it involves developing an individual project. There is a curriculum included with the experience, so you're not on your own here. We're going to be offering you free opportunities to learn more about how to do social impact, how to use your talents for good, how to find your purpose. And so those are part of the actual RISE Challenge experience. Then last but not least, the project is due on February the 16th, but you'll be finishing the challenge by February 23rd. And that just involves doing some peer reviews of other projects. And this is a very important step for us. We ask that you also review and learn about the projects that other members of the community are working on and participate in the assessment process as a member of the RISE community and in order to be eligible for the benefits of the RISE challenge. So at this point, Nataliia, I will ask you please just to talk a little bit about obviously what I said, but as well as what it was like for you to do these steps, what you learned, what you enjoyed. And then after this slide, you'll be talking more about your project specifically.
Тож, як податися у RISE? Перше, вам треба записати два відео про себе до 22 грудня, і також вам треба буде продивитися кілька відео з інших людей, хто подається на RISE, та оцінити за певною шкалою. Після цього ви зможете відкрити вже доступ до вашого другого етапу подачі RISE. Це найголовніший етап, це створення власного проєкту, який має певний соціальний імпакт на ваше ком'юніті. Але RISE буде допомагати вам з тим, як правильно побудувати свій проєкт. У вас буде багато статей, багато відео від RISE, які ви можете передивитися, якщо у вас немає ідеї, як правильно створювати свій проєкт, як його організувати, як його описувати. Тому навіть якщо ви ніколи не робили нічого такого в своєму житті, все буде добре. І після цього до 23 лютого ви маєте завершити повністю свою аплікаційну форму. Ви маєте продивитися проєкти інших фіналістів, інших людей, хто подається до RISE. І також ви маєте пройти невеликий квіз на логіку. Як на мене, подача в RISE була дуже унікальним досвідом через те, що воно не вимагало жодних есе чи якихось екзаменів. Це було дійсно щось інноваційне. І, як на мене, це було набагато цікавіше, ніж написати есе на різні теми. І зараз я буду говорити більше про свій проєкт.
So after you've completed those stages, then you're eligible to become a finalist or a winner of the experience. And we've talked a lot about that already. One thing I will mention, and Nataliia, maybe you can say just a few words, is that if you're chosen to be a finalist, you'll participate in an interview process. And the interview day is a very intricate experience and involves individual presentations, group debates, projects, teamwork. It's a really interesting, but I think pretty cool experience to have the opportunity to participate as one of the finalist interview days. Could you just mention a few things about that, Nataliia?
Так, коли ви пройдете у топ 500 фіналістів, які були відібрані, ви маєте пройти день фіналіста, у якому ви будете мати інтерв'ю з представниками RISE, та також багато групових завдань, де ви будете вирішувати різні креативні проблеми з людьми з усього світу. Як на мене, це було дуже цікавий досвід. Це завдяки цьому дню я знайшла багато друзів з усіх куточків земної кулі. І це було дійсно дуже цікаво. І так.
Okay, so now we'll have the opportunity to hear from Nataliia a bit about her RISE project. And just before I start talking about she starts talking about the project, just say like, we are open to any and all kinds of projects. We just want to hear about how you want to solve the world's problems. And it can be using art, it can be using science, it can be using technology, it can be using an interdisciplinary approach. It can be problems related to disability access, gender equity, education access, human rights, sustainability, the environment. We are open to any and all ideas. So let me just flip here to this part for Nataliia to talk more about her project.
Отож, як Грек сказав, Райс дивляться на те, яким чином ви можете змінити, вирішити певні проблеми за допомогою того своїх знань у певній сфері. Це не обов'язково має бути технологія, це має бути сфера, яка вам дійсно цікава. То наука, чи мистецтво, чи програмування. Зараз я буду говорити про свій проєкт, який був більше технологічним, і я його робила з іншим глобальним фіналістом RISE Василем Абрамовичем. Next slide, please.
I think he's on the call, Vasil, right? Are you, you join us today, second RISE finalist from Ukraine. Are you here? I don't know, maybe he doesn't hear us, but it would be great if you just, you know, send a note and say hi to everyone, because we have three finalists from Ukraine, RISE finalists. And I see Vasil Abramovich on the call. It must be him.
про що був наш проєкт? Отож, наш проєкт був спрямований на допомогу людям з вадами слуху через те, що в Україні багато людей з вадами слуху не мають доступу до гарного обслуговування у громадських місцях, таких як магазини або навіть там поліція чи лікарні. І, як на мене, це велика проблема. І у нашому проєкті ми намагалися це вирішити з допомогою штучного інтелекту. Next slide, please. Can you play the video?
Yes.
Thank you. Отож, ми розробили штучний інтелект, який міг розпізнавати жести, українською жестовою мовою, і виводити це на екран. Ви можете бачити на цьому слайді. Так воно працювало. Next slide, please. І чого це було важливо? Це було важливо через те, що з допомогою нашої програми ми намагалися дати нечуючим людям можливість бути почутими, бути дійсно почутими у громадських місцях і бути на одному рівні з усіма іншими людьми.
Next slide.
Yeah, I'm done. Thank you.
Okay. Great. So, just in summation, we'll be going to questions and answers now. Just want to remind you, we'll be having some larger events coming up in a couple of weeks. You'll be able to hear from more RISE winners. These are open to anyone if you want to go. If you're in Ukraine and you want to go to the one that's going to be for Africa or Asia, you're more than welcome. It's just going to be winners from those regions talking about their projects, talking about their experiences, similar to what you saw today, but with more perspectives from other RISE participants. And those sign-up links will be going out in a future email. And then, of course, please don't forget, download the app Hello World. This QR code here will take you there and get started on your stage one part of your application so that you can become part of the RISE community and participate in the challenge. So thank you again so much, Nataliia. It was great. You could have just been making fun of me the whole time you were talking. I don't really know. But I think it sounded like it was a really cool presentation and the videos were incredible. So thanks again for having us. And we'll be happy to now spend some time answering questions. You can also follow us on social media. We have an Instagram account that's posting a lot of stuff about the challenge and the launch of the challenge for this year. And again, the QR code is there for you to download the app. So thanks again.
Thank you so much, friends. That was wonderful. Thank you for all your presentations. And also, I wanted to say that actually, Nataliia, she represents not only RISE and UDS community, but you also introduce represent, sorry, Manne community, right? Junior Academy of Science. And I know there are many Manne students here on the call. So I think that's the wonderful opportunity for you guys, because you know already how to research, what to offer, how to present yourself. And I mean, probably every second of you knows how to deliver, you know, small projects, and already been working on some really cool things that may change, not necessarily the world, but your community, right? And then RISE will help you scale. So baby steps, but yeah, just the first step, just apply, try yourself. You need to try you never know if you're gonna get to the winner stage or not before you try. Так, тому всіх манівців закликаю спробувати свої сили і обов'язково подаватися на цю програму, бо у вас є тут всі скіли необхідні для того, щоб дійти до останнього етапу. І знову ж таки, RISE wasn't that popular even one year ago, right? And we got 3 Ukrainians already among 100 global winners. So you guys have even more chances right now with all this awareness and knowing what you know, what RISE needs from you and what's exactly they're waiting from you. So I think your chances are even higher. So please apply. Я дуже вболіваю за всіх студентів з України і сподіваюся, що цього року їх буде набагато більше, ніж троє. Добре, і зараз це time for Q&As, да? Тобто ми зараз будемо брати ваші питання. Будь ласка, задавайте. Ви можете підняти руку і тоді я вас просто анмючу, чи ви можете писати питання в чаті, але це унікальна можливість зараз отримати відповідь на все, що вас цікавить про RISE. And before our students and their parents formulate their questions, I think really important message that you, Greg, said, and just maybe you can repeat it again. I think there is a confusion or a misrepresentation, or I don't know how to call this, but some students think that if they're not social leaders, in other words, if they if they cannot lead the community and they are more like STEM people, RISE is not for them. And for some reason, it's not right, right? So can you just elaborate on this?
Absolutely. This is an important point. I think there is a misperception that to be a part of a community like this and to be have a chance of winning the finalists or the winner scholarship, that you need to be an extroverted kind of political exactly. type leader. This is not the case at all. We have many people who have won the competition who are scientists, who work in the background, who are maybe introverted, who are artists, who are not the type of, you know, Kennedy-esque or whatever, use your example, person who is a leader of people who wants to be out front. This is very much a community that's diverse in every form, not just in the international backgrounds and the languages, but also in the types of intelligence that we're looking for. This is not just a community for the kind of stereotypical leader. If you have a really good idea, that involves using your artistic skills. There was one young woman who won one of the awards who used, she created an animated series about the experience of being homeless, and she's super introverted, and like her all the voices in the animated series were voiced by other friends of hers from her school community. We had a young man who used data from the Canadian EPA to predict earthquakes in the northern parts of Canada. This doesn't involve having to interact with any other people to create something like that. You can do it using data analyses and skills and technology. There are so many examples of young people who did projects very much, you know, using their skills, but on their own, who didn't need to start an entire movement. Now, there were also kids or young people who did start a movement, and that was part of what they were trying to do. But we are open to all the diversity of talents and diversity of ideas. The important thing is how much social impact can you have? It's not about one type of person or one type of skill.
That's really cool. I hope всі тут зрозуміли в двох словах. Не лише якщо ви соціальний лідер, ви маєте подаватися на RISE, навіть якщо ви більше такий STEM-орієнтований, математик, ви все одно маєте спробувати свої сили. Якщо ви можете аналізувати дані, наприклад, да, там є приклад молодої людини, який проаналізувавши дані, там зміг спрогнозувати землетруси в Канаді, там чи якісь інші штуки, які не обов'язково вимагають від вас бути екстравертом. да, лише ваші знання, бажання змінити щось, показати, ну, запропонувати якийсь такий міні-стартап, да, чи якусь інновацію, чи просто вашу ідею, як щось можна змінити в цьому світі, будь ласка, робити, робіть це. Да. Інше питання, чи do you need to have good English to apply to RISE? So what's the English level for RISE?
This is a great question. So I would say that two barriers to entry are one, that you are between 15 and 17. And two, you have to have what I would say is a basic intermediate level of English. A low basic is not going to help or not going to be enough probably for being a winner. Although I do think that the RISE experience itself can very much help you improve your English if it's something you're trying to do. So that's also another thing. If you're 15 and you're not so sure of your English, you can spend a year doing RISE, improving your English, communicating on the Discord, doing the project. And then maybe next year you will have the English level to actually compete for the scholarship. But generally speaking, you know, we're not testing or screening for English. We're not asking you to complete an exam like the TOEFL or Duolingo or anything like that. But the app at this point, it only is in English. So you have to have the level of English to read the app, to interact with the app, and then to present your project in English and participate in an interview. So mm-hmm. that's the level. I would say intermediate is probably where I would call it. You know, if you know the Cambridge levels, like probably a B1. A B1 would be the minimum you would need to apply, but we're not asking you to take an exam or prove that. It's just exactly. kind of my favorite way to understand it. If you want to add anything, Nataliia, on the English experience, feel free, but.
Тобто я думаю, що всі зрозуміли, да? Тобто B1 це такі, ну, найкращі рівні, які вам потрібно ще поступити в RISE, але він може бути і менше, ніж B1, тобто intermediate, але ви його підтягнете за рік цих всіх челенджів з RISE, і в принципі, якщо у вас є бажання свій англійський розвивати, то це все дуже можливо і з більш низьким рівнем. Ніяких тестів від вас не вимагаються, це дуже важливо. I think there was one question. Thank you for a great presentation. Thank you. Is it possible to present project you've already started as the RISE challenge? Actually, maybe you just join us later because Nataliia actually did show her project with RISE. You can watch the recording afterwards and see what she offered, what she offered and why RISE chose her as a global finalist. What is RISE looking for in projects? What important for a project to stand out?
That you have an impact, that you're able to solve problems, that you're able to make the world a better place using your talents. There's no other parameters other than that. And there was I understood the question really quick. Sorry, Julia. You can use a project you've been working on. We ask that if you've been working on it before RISE, you present a new component, that you create something different and add to it. It's okay to have already existed, but we want you to have the curricular experience of the design process. So that's the only thing to be aware of, or it can be a new project. That's up to you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, супер. Це зрозуміло, да? Тобто, знову ж таки, основне питання, що ви маєте щось змінити, ви хочете покращити цей світ. Знову ж таки, дивіться на це не лише, що якщо це світовий проект, да, то це треба подаватися раз. Якщо він на рівні школи, то я вже не буду подаватися раз. Це неправильний approach, тому що RISE will help you scale. I'm just trying to explain that it's not only like if you're thinking of yourself as a global leader and you need to change the world. It's not necessarily the world, it's maybe like a little problem like changing something on your community level, right? Or just district level. And then RISE will help you scale so that they don't look like, oh my God, it's not possible for me to, it's too much.
This is important. This is an important point, Julia. Yes, right. Fix something in your school, fix something right. in your neighborhood and show us you've solved a problem that we can then help. Okay, you've done this in this community in Ukraine. Let us help you scale it to your region of Ukraine. Let us help you scale it to the whole country of Ukraine. Let us help you scale it through Europe, through the EU, through the whole world, wherever it can be scaled.
Got it. Thank you. And також Грек сказав, що якщо у вас є якийсь там свій проєкт, яким же ви працювали, it's okay подаватися з ним, лише внесіть якийсь новий компонент в цей проєкт при подачі в RISE, да? То, щоб щось таке маленьке нове в цьому проєкті, але все ж таки було присутнє, щоб ви якийсь все ж таки такий ефорт зробили для того, щоб податися в RISE, його покращили, чи якимось іншим чином його налаштували, щоб він не трошки новий, не такий, яким там, які вже там запустили пару років тому, да? Також one of the questions was if they can apply to rise twice in a row in case if they are eligible age-wise. So let's say, okay.
Yes, so if you applied last year and you're still eligible age, you can apply again. Okay. As long as you're eligible age-wise, you can apply more than once. And then the same question, I saw the duration of the program. So you see here, the minute you complete stage one, you have the ability to start stage two. So that depends. If you complete it today, you have an extra 20 days or so, 23 days to work on the project than if you complete it in December 20th. But the deadline for submitting the project is the 16th of February.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you. One of the questions was, should the project solve some specific problems which is proposed by RISE program, or can I choose something by myself? I think we've already addressed this.
Anything.
You can, right, anything, it could be anything. Just choose it, like, be creative. It's like, it's not like RISE give you a particular question that you need to answer. No, this is the beauty of it. You can pick up whatever and just try to solve it on your level. And
I can give one piece of advice here on this idea. Mm-hmm. One thing we tell people to think about is think about the intersection of what you're good at, what you like doing, and what the world needs, right? That's a good way to think about your problem, like what problem to solve, okay? So the intersection of what you're good at, what you like doing, and what the world needs, and then identify how you can use your talents in that area.
Right. Дуже крута штука. Запишіть собі, да, what you're good at. Тобто вам треба знайти щось таке, в чому ви дійсно непогано розбираєтесь, да? Що вам подобається робити? І що ви думаєте, цей світ потребує? Це, якщо у вас буде така інтерсекція цих трьох направлень, да, тобто в чому ви розбираєтесь і що ви любите, і що ви думаєте, цей світ потребує, то це якраз і буде на 70-80% правильний проект для Райсу, тому що ви не просто, знаєте, щось будете вигадувати, придумувати, ніж би податися до Райс, а ви просто свої навички, скіли через якийсь проект, який вам дійсно подобається, да? Можете запропонувати світу і щось змінити, і таким чином Райс це дуже запрешейтить, тому що ви робите те, що вам дійсно подобається, що вам цікаво, а це, як правило, вже половина успіху, да? Тому це дуже важливий момент, який треба запам'ятати. One of the questions is also, can I submit a group project if other participants are not participating in RISE?
Yeah, so you can submit a project that you have help with, that you have collaborators. That's totally fine. People can be supporting you, but it's just that it's, as you've said, it's an individual submission. So you can only submit for yourself. You cannot submit as a group, if that makes sense.
Okay, then it's actually, I have a question. So with Nataliia and Vasily Abramovich, so you worked on the same project and you submitted it as individual projects, or Vasily submitted something completely different and then also got to the global winners? Vasily? Я не знаю, чи він нас чує, але Наташа, може ти відповіш, зможеш відповісти на запитання?
Та ми працювали над одним проєктом, ми разом його подали. Ми розкрили цей проєкт трішки з різних боків у наших окремих аплікаційних формах, але це був один та самий проєкт, одна програма.
Круто. So it was one project, but you just presented it from different angles and from different what your like strongest parts, yeah? But the project was about the same thing.
Yes.
That's really cool.
Cool. And that's fine. It's just that it has to, they didn't present it as a team. They present one person to present one person to present the other part, and they can be collaborating. That's fine.
That's cool. All right. What should be said in the representative video? I mean, should it be said about goals or something like this? I think Nataliia mentioned that there is a, like a guidance, right? What exactly you need to show when you start uploading the video, right? RISE will tell you more, like what exactly they expect from you. Так, Nataliia, чи ні?
Так. У вас буде конкретні питання, на які вам треба дати відповіді у першій частині. І у другій частині у вас буде багато guidance щодо того, що саме розкривати в вашому проєкті, на які потенційні питання можна типу відповісти, коли ви будете презентувати свій проєкт.
Ага. Окей, тобто вам треба почати, а там ви вже розберетесь, що конкретно від вас вимагають, на які конкретні питання треба відповісти. І там буде гайданс, про який можна буде прочитати. Я не дуже розумію питання, чи я правильно зрозумів, увесь райс буде крутитися навколо якогось одного мого проєкту. Райс не буде крутитись навколо вашого проєкту. Ви маєте крутитися таким чином, щоб презентувати ваш проєкт до райсу, да? Тобто ви ж розумієте. How many applications again, Greg, last year?
So we had about 50,000 people sign up for the program, but mm-hmm. that completed the completed stage one was a smaller number, and then completed the full projects was a smaller number than that. Okay. So it's like depends on which way you look at it, but we had 50,000 download the app and sign up.
50,000. So 50,000 людей зі всього світу будуть даунлодити цей аплікейшн, да, і подавати. Ну, не всі будуть подаватися з цих 50,000, хтось не дійде до там дедлайну 22 грудня, до речі, да, у вас місяць залишився. Навіть якщо це половина, навіть if it's a half of 50,000, just 25 people applying, right? Or it's
yeah, I mean that finished number. The project was a much smaller number, right? So only of the 50,000, 35,000 complete stage one, so right. Complete the profile, do all of this, and then in order to be eligible for the scholarship, you have to complete all the way to the end. So right. The number keeps going down the further you go.
Right, so there are no tests, but there are many people applying from all over the world. So you have competitors from all over the world. So it's you really need to do something unique and think about it. Think about a unique project. Again, just think of this intersection, as Greg mentioned, what you're good at, what you're like doing, and what world needs, right?
Yeah, I would add really quickly too that the experience of completing the project is educational. You're going to learn how to do this with us. You're not expected to invent this all with no guidance. And I don't know, because I don't understand the Ukrainian part, like Nataliia may have spoken a bit about it, this, like there's a curriculum that's incorporated and we're building that curriculum all the time. New guest speakers, new experts teaching classes about how to do this kind of work, that kind of thing. So inherently, whether you win or you don't, you're going to learn skills, you're going to benefit, you're going to get a new community, you're going to make friends. We also offer workshops about other things that are not RISE, like University of Chicago is a partner. They are presenting about admissions for US universities, helping people do that kind of thing. We have scholarship opportunities that are being presented and offered on the app, that there's a lot of other things happening other than just the project as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, thank you. Nataliia mentioned this already. Thank you for repeating this again. So it's not like you're going to be there alone. There's going to be a lot of guidance. You just need to download link and then try to see what they're asking and just, read more guidance as you go. All right. Do we have more questions? Where can we contact you? Is only Hello Earth or something else?
Hello World is the app. You can go on the website. They have lots of frequently asked questions. If you have questions, I would recommend going to the frequently asked question list to start. And then there's also an email contact on the website if you have other questions that are not answered by the website.
I think, Nataliia, if you can provide our group of people your email address, what do you think? If they have questions, may they reach out to you or maybe through Facebook? What's the best way to reach out to you?
I think email works the best.
Perfect. If you can then just drop it maybe in this chat box would be great. Also, I wanted to say that once again, it's important that you guys download the link that I've several times already put in the chat box, because it's important that TRICE will track students from Ukraine through that link. So either the link that either the QR code that Greg showed on his screen or the link that I've sent in the chat box, but it's important that you download your app through those links. Okay. Also, if you have more questions, feel free to join RISE sessions. Rest sessions for Europe, rest sessions for Africa, anyone, as long as the time works for you. Again, you can see it up, right? So RISE Regional Summit Americas, it's 7 p.m. Eastern time. on 13th of December, Africa 14th of December. They're going to talk about the same thing. It's just for, you know, they're regional. So probably the most appropriate for you would be Europe and the Middle East. But again, if this date doesn't work for you, you can join another regional summit. I'll copy paste and again, just send it to you for information. And where can they find the Zoom links for those events?
So the Zoom link signups, so Julia, I send you them, and I was wondering maybe you can include them in the follow-up email.
All right, they're linked. Yeah,
they will be linked in the follow-up email you'll be receiving. And I will, yeah, that should be best.
You guys, please follow our Facebook page, like it so that you can see all our updates all the time. We write about UGS, write about RISE, and we'll definitely provide you with the links to those regional summits that you can join, okay? So follow UGS Facebook page where we update on the, like, I don't know, daily basis. So you have also email on Nataliia here. You can also you also see the Greg sent you the frequently asked question link, and again download the app through the link that in the chat box or QR code that Greg showed you, and we have like 4 more minutes for questions if you guys have some or not. Feel free to also share this information with your friends. I think that's important. Again, you can individually submit the same project, right? So maybe it's going to be a support for you to submit with your friends so that you are not alone in this RISE application process. It's much fun. And both of you may win, you know, with the same project as we just learned. So that's great, isn't it? So yeah, please tell your friends. Where can the entry be found? What do you mean the entry? The link to download the... to download the app, I can send you once again.
Yeah, so the follow-up email, we posted the QR code, and I know this will be recorded. I don't know if it'll be posted, and you can scan it there. And then follow-up email, we'll include the link and as well as the information for the summit coming up next month.
Mm-hmm. So again, link, again, this link, here it is. You just need to download it through you. Just copy paste it. I don't know. Just save it somewhere on your PC. Send it to your social media and download it from the app. Just click on this link on your mobile phone and you'll get the application to download. The link is here in the chat box. But again, we'll also send you this presentation. If you send it to me, I'll forward it. And also that will have all this information.
Julia, will you post this presentation somewhere? That was a question I came in.
I can send it to this group, right? We will also post this video.
Great.
And I can also just in the comments of you know, below the video, I can post the link to this presentation. If you download it to the Google Drive or somewhere, not a problem.
Great. Okay. Wonderful. Yes.
Thank you, friends. Thank you so much, Greg, for joining us on this Sunday. And Nataliia, thank you so much for sharing your combined UGS RISE experience. And we are so proud of you. We're also proud of Vasily Abramovich, who is not UGS finalist, but finalist from Ukraine. And I know you applied to UGS, actually. But, you know, you see, RISE is another way to get to your, to reach out to your dream and, you know, just get what you want. In the end, just studying at the best college, hopefully on the full scholarship. So congratulations to you. I'm so happy. Many Ukrainians, please do apply to different project, different programs, not only UGS. I'm so proud of all of you to be persistent and never giving up and applying to other projects that in the end turn out to be the one that we work with right now. So that's amazing, guys. I'm really proud of you. So go Ukrainians. I wish you good luck, all the best. And yeah, please share your please share this information with everyone you know. Have a wonderful day and evening for you guys in Ukraine. Stay in touch.
Thank you, everybody. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Thanks.